Hello everybody and welcome, this is Spoonie with another shipbuilding tutorial for Starbase. In this video, we're going to go over the ISAN, which is essentially space GPS. I'm going to show you how it works and how to set it up. I'd like to first give credit to the authors of this script. That is Collective. I did not personally write a single line of this script. I'm simply showing you how to set it up and how it works. So this time for YOLOL, we're just going to be copying and pasting directly from the PDF provided by Collective, who again are the authors of this. For those of you who are interested in a little more information about how it works, you can find that information there, as well as the YOLOL code, and I'll link it in the description. So we're going to start by putting down four hard points. I would suggest using large hard points so that you don't need to worry about spacing them out, and do try to put these as close as you can to one another, but they don't need to be right next to each other. Make sure you add cables to those. And then we're gonna go back to our asset browser and we're gonna add small turret turntables to each of these hardpoints. Once our hardpoints are down and we've got our turntables attached, we'll go back to the asset browser and we'll look for a small navigation receiver. These function exactly the same as the navigation receivers, they're just smaller. So now we're gonna place one of these navigation receivers onto each of the small turntables. And it doesn't matter which direction they're facing, but if for aesthetic reasons you want them to face different directions, they'll function exactly the same. Make sure everything is bolted down. And then again, be sure that you have added cables to the bottom of your hardpoints. Next, we're going to need to change some name values. So select one of your small receivers, and it's important to notice that when you select it, there are two options here. The small navigation receiver, as well as the turret base. We're not going to change anything on the turret base, so just click over to the small navigation receiver, and we'll change the listening angle first from the default of 45 to 180. And this is why it's important to have the small turret turntable. Without the turntable, this can't go beyond 45, and your ISAN will not function. Next, we're going to change the signal strength to just the letter A, and the target message to just AT. We're going to do the exact same thing for all four of our receivers, except our second one we will name B and BT, C and CT, and our last we'll name D and DT. Double check that you've named everything correctly. And then we're ready to move on. So before we get into YOLOL, we're gonna set up a text panel. Make sure you bolt this down. And then we're going to change the panel value name to just an underscore, one single underscore. And now that's set up and ready. We can get into YOLOL. So for this, you can use a basic YOLOL chip, but if you want to use the speedometer function, you need to make sure you're using an advanced YOLOL chip. So in our asset browser, we're going to pull up a chip socket and an advanced YOLOL chip. Make sure it's bolted down and make sure you've added cables to your socket. For this next part, we're literally just going to copy and paste the lines directly from the PDF into our YOLOL script editor. Instead of including this YOLOL script in the description or linking it in the comments, because this is not my own work, I'm instead going to link to the PDF of Collective, who did write this. Now that we've copied and pasted all of the YOLOL lines, we need to change the code in one way in order to use the speedometer. If you're not planning to use the speedometer, you can skip this step, but if you do want to use it, you need to change on the first line the SP equals 0 to SP equals 1. That's the only change you'll need to make. Now that that's all set up, we can jump into test mode and see how this works. On the text panel, you can see our X, Y, and Z coordinates begin to propagate. And sometimes when you first start ISAN, the speed value, or the S, on your text panel will sometimes show a number that isn't zero. That doesn't mean it's not working, it just means that it needs a moment to boot up. If you'd like to restart ISAN, or you're having problems, or you're streaming and you don't want somebody to stream snipe you, you can just bring up your universal tool, and in this value field, you can just select the entire line by pressing Ctrl A and delete it. Then just press Enter, and what this will do is turn ISAN offline. You can see on the text panel, it now reads ISAN offline. To boot it back up, all you do is the exact same process a second time, and it will reboot. Now we'll test out the speedometer and make sure that's working as well. As you can see, as we begin to move, the value S, which is our speed, at the bottom of our text panel begins to increase. And that's everything you need. In a few minutes, you can have ISAN up and running on any ship. If you'd like to add ISAN to a ship that you already have that's not in the editor, you can buy any of these components on the auction house. They're not particularly expensive. I'd like to again thank Collective for their incredible work.